We're already seeing how a warmer planet is changing life for all living things. Right now, the Earth is 1.2 degrees Celsius warmer than averages from 1850 to 1900, known as pre-industrial levels. So far, we're adapting to the changes this causes. But if the planet warms by more than 1.5 degrees Celsius, it's more likely that the consequences will overwhelm us. Scientists agree that 1.5 degrees is the tipping point into uncertainty. So world leaders have set this as the tolerable limit to global temperature increase. How did they decide this? What does warming of 1.5 degrees or more look like? If today's trends continue, sometime between 2030 and 2052, that's in 10 to 30 years from now, the Earth will be more than 1.5 degrees warmer than pre-industrial levels. Carrying on as we are means a 2.7 degree increase by the end of the century. Species of insects, plants, and animals are already dying off and losing their habitats. We're seeing extreme weather and rising sea levels. Our health, livelihoods, food security, water supply, and economies will suffer. Risks vary from region to region, but at 2 degrees warmer or more, all risks are more likely and will have a stronger impact. Flooding and heat waves could happen annually, not just once a decade. Millions more people will face water scarcity. Millions of people all over the world are likely to be affected by sea level rises. Large parts of major cities like London will flood regularly. Some areas could be completely submerged. The conflicts over scarce resources and displaced populations that will follow will affect us all, and many of these impacts will be irreversible. So how do we limit warming? Like an insulating blanket, greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, chief among them carbon dioxide, are trapping heat from escaping back into space. The Earth's well-established energy balance created a stable climate for thousands of years, but it's now being disrupted. Continuous measurements of atmospheric CO2 have been taken in Hawaii since 1958, creating a record of steadily rising levels. Since the 1990s, CO2 levels have risen even more quickly. And it was in the 1990s that governments and coalitions across the world finally began to take coordinated action to slow the warming. 1992. 197 countries adopt the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, the UNFCCC, to respond to the threat of continued warming. From this arose the annual conference of the parties, the COP, to negotiate climate action on a global scale. 1997. COP3 in Kyoto leads to the Kyoto Protocol, a commitment to national targets to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. It also creates emissions permit trading, known as carbon markets, which we'll look at more in another video. 2015, COP21 in Paris sees 193 nations agree to intensify efforts towards a sustainable low-carbon future. These nations pledge to limit warming to under 2 degrees this century, ideally less. 2021, COP26 in Glasgow reviews progress and concludes that more needs to be done. In the climate pact that comes out of discussions, the president of the conference says that the 1.5 degrees warming target is alive, but its pulse is weak. Making sure that global warming doesn't exceed 1.5 degrees by 2100 is considered achievable, realistic, and will enable sustainable climate-resilient development. Targets agreed in Paris are regularly under review. Governments and companies are acting to reduce emissions, and the window of opportunity is still open. The most recent report by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change indicates that a great deal of transformation needs to happen this decade. However, while great strides have been made in expediting measures, such as cheaper renewable energy, experts agree that there is still untapped potential in the tech and policy worlds to allow regular people to make more climate-friendly choices. We're not starting from zero, so every tiny increase in temperature affects the planet's systems. But this means that every tiny reduction in greenhouse gas emissions matters too. The actions you take today do have an impact on tomorrow.